It is quite a paradox that despite all the positive stereotypes of the sigma personality, a good number of men and women of this personality type are still broke as hell. All sigma men and women alike suffer from one thing, inertia. The inability to take prompt action because of procrastination and analysis paralysis. Sigmas want to be thorough, precise and all-knowing before they take on a new project, which is good and at the same time bad because the longer they take to figure out things, the greater the force of inertia exerted on them. It is crystal clear that sigmas have very rich imaginations through which ideas are generated in thousands or even tens of thousands. An exaggerated example to show you how ginormous their brain power can be. Having a creative and rich imaginative brain does not necessarily translate into wealth. Sigmas need to overcome the feeling of inertia to reach their full potentials and claim their birthright, because they were born smart and well endowed from birth to take on any task that is difficult and at the same time fun to do, like achieving financial freedom. However, since inertia is the cost of many sigmas being broke with million-dollar ideas in their heads, it would be nice to look at ways in which sigmas can tell if they are suffering from inertia. Self-doubt is the number one symptom of inertia. It paralyzes the sigma's self-confidence and self-beliefs. When sigmas start second-guessing their abilities to carry through with an idea, they start looking for excuses and reasons as to why so-and-so idea won't work. Instead of going with the flow, they may turn to procrastinate because it confers them with a certain degree of self-actualization in that it delays execution while reassuring the sigma that they have not given up on the idea yet. By so doing, they are shielded from the pain that comes with self-defeat or failure. Analysis paralysis is a side effect of overthinking and in trying to predict the end results before you even start. In the state of inertia, the sigma is prone to planning and replanning, checking and double-checking details and the unwillingness to compromise with any possibility of failure. One of the basic fears of the sigma is a fear of failure. They don't want to waste their time and limited energy on something they are sure will fail off the bat. At inertia, sigmas lack the mental clarity to know if an idea will fail off the bat or not. Sigmas stand in the way of their own progress when they allow procrastination and analysis paralysis to steer their wheels of progress. We all know that the genesis of wealth generation is by saving up a startup capital and then investing it or starting up a business of your own. Sigmas have the ability to do so because they are naturally minimalist and can live frugally to achieve any financial goal. But as we all know, it takes a lot of self-discipline and courage to keep aside 10 to 30% of your money in a savings account for later use. Because sigmas are hardwired to the cause and effect model of life, they will be effective at taking immediate action if the long-term effect of their inaction will have a more devastating effect on their financial freedom. Here are 5 signs or causes that sigmas can use to overcome inertia and the fear of failure to start saving right away or die broke. If you have a job, the first logical thing to do once you get paid is to pay yourself before anyone else. George Clanson explains why sigmas should pay themselves first in his book, The Richest Man in Babylon. According to this book, when we get paid at the end of each month, we forget to pay ourselves because we pay the landlord, the grocery store owners, our mortgage and monthly subscription first and forget to pay ourselves. Sigmas are prone to this effect when they choose to put the needs of others before theirs. He says that 10% of your monthly pay should be kept aside in a savings account every month no matter what. 20% should be used to pay your debts or student loans if you have any, and 70% for your monthly expenses. The good news here is that sigmas have the mental fortitude and the self-discipline to keep away a fraction of their money for long-term use if they want, because they are able of projecting 5 to 10 years into the future. If you desire to be rich, do what Napoleon Hill says in his book, Think and Grow Rich. He says that the first step to getting rich is by having a burning desire to become rich and then working towards it. To him, desire is different from hoping or wishful thinking. Desire means work and sacrifice towards a particular cause. So, if you desire riches and financial freedom, start fattening thy purse now. Because wishful thinking, according to Elon Musk, a Sigma male, is the main cause of why we don't succeed. Because instead of working hard, people spend their time wishing for more and hoping that things should never change but remain the same. But we live in a dynamic world where anything can happen at any time. If you have a business idea, the second logical thing to do as a Sigma is start saving for that idea immediately you finish drawing a business plan for the idea. By doing so, you solve 30% of your inertia and pave the way for investment opportunities, because nobody is going to invest in your idea if you don't believe in it. Once you find yourself in a romantic relationship and foresee the possibility of marriage, you need to start saving money against the future. Start saving for your home, kids' tuition, car before you even get there. Don't buy into the philosophy of we will figure it out when we get there. Not preparing at the beginning is preparing to fail. If you are 19 and below watching with a savings account, kudos to you and more grace to your elbow, for your future is almost 100% guaranteed. Once you get to your 20s, you need to start thinking of strategies on how to keep aside a part of the little you are making from side hustles. If you don't start saving in your 20s, your chances of dying broke or ending up in the streets are very high. The way we approach money and the whole concept of financial freedom has a lot to play in the way we handle money and how we go about getting money. Luck and the lottery mentality is another habit preventing Sigmas from saving. Even though Sigmas don't believe in luck, but in the state of inertia, because they want an easy way out, they may give into such thoughts. Most opportunities are missed because we are never ready nor prepared to take on them at the appropriate time. A word to the wise is...